Hi everyone, this is Lénorde and today we are talking about Betaflight 4.2, the newest version of this firmware. First, I will show you every settings you need to pay attention to when updating to Betaflight 4.2, and then we will take a look at all the new features, right after the logo. Here we are with a flight controller that I have just flashed with Betaflight 4.2, and this warning here is just because I need to calibrate my accelerometer. Now I will go into the configuration tab, but before anything, do not copy and paste any settings from previous version of Betaflight. This will not work. You have to start from zero. Here in this configuration tab, you may notice that there is one thing that has changed, and it is the gyro update frequency that is now locked. You cannot change that setting anymore. The reason is because Betaflight developers decided to lock that value to your native gyro frequency. A lower value would result in downsampling and could cause artifacts. Now we want to work with a clean signal, and that is very good. The next update is not visible, but it's definitely there. The PID loop frequency has been optimized and now it requires much less CPU than before, which means that F4 boards and F7 boards are both able to run 8K, 8K and have the RPM filters enabled. Before that, the F4 boards would require to run at 4K, 4K to work with the RPM filters, but now it has changed, and that's a very, very good thing. It is a huge optimization of the Betaflight software. To make sure that 8K, 8K works on your board, you need to go into the CLI and type tasks, and then you check the PID to make sure that it's running at 8K. If this number is lower than 8000, you may need to run 4K PID loop rate. So now that I made sure that 8K, 8K works on my board, I can just leave those settings, and I can also leave D-Shot at 600. Now I will activate bidirectional D-Shot because I want to run RPM filters. You need to count your motor pulls here, nothing has changed. And the rest of this page is exactly the same as before. In the PID profile settings, you may notice that I have changed the D value to D max. It doesn't change the way it works, it's just a new name so you can understand easily what each column is actually doing. It's just a new way to name that value, nothing else. There is no other visible change in this tab, but you have to know that anti-gravity is now working differently than before. Before that, anti-gravity was proportional to your I value and it would multiply them, but now it is a fixed value that will be added to your I, so you can boost your I as much as you want, the anti-gravity will have the same overall effect. It will add the same amount of I when you are punching the throttle. So you will have to retune your anti-gravity because it's not the same as before. The last thing I want to say about this tab is that the item relax cutoff value has been raised to 15. They do advise to lower that value if you want a more smooth or cinematic flight experience. So I'm going to lower that value to 10. There are now new ways to set your rates. On this drop-down menu, you can find race flight and chase version of the rates, and then actual and quick rates, which are new and developed by Betaflight. If you change this, you will have to set your rates from default. It doesn't transfer your previous settings, so make sure that you are a new rate profile if you change that and you want to create new rates. The good thing is that you can set your max rate immediately in degrees per second. So if you need 900 max rate, you can just enter that number. It is a bit easier than before, but if you are used to the Betaflight system, it may not be a huge update for you. It just may be easier for some people. In the filter settings, one thing has changed, and it is the way to set your dynamic notch filter. Before that, you could set it to low, medium, or high, but now you can precisely enter the min hertz and max hertz of your notch filter. So, if you are using RPM filter, you want it to set to low, so it can filter the lower frequencies, and it converts to 90, to 350 Hz. That is exactly the same as before if you were using low. For the dynamic notch tune, 250 will be a good value, because with the new PID loop optimization, your motors are supposed to be cooler and the filters are supposed to be a bit more effective, so you can go a bit more aggressive than the previous version of Betaflight and still have cool motors when you land. So if you want to go a bit more aggressive with your filters, you can push them a bit more than before. And that is why Betaflight 4.2 is a huge update for both F4 and F7 board users. There is one more additional feature that has been activated by default on Betaflight 4.2, and it is the FF Interpolate. Here, you can see the different values that are allowed. If you want to change it, you will need to use the CLI for now. If you want a smoother feed forward, you can go up to a value of average 3 or average 4. It will just give you a more smooth cinematic flying style. But the default value of average 2 will just work well for most of us. You only need to change it if you want to smooth your feed forward even more than this new value. If you want to discover all the other new features that are not activated by default, you can check them out on the Betaflight 4.2 tuning notes. The link is in the description below. It is mainly small details that will require a lot of black box to tune properly. So if the defaults work for you, don't worry about it. But if you want to go deeper into Betaflight 4.2, this will give you all the information you actually need. And there are also quick settings that you can copy and paste into the CLI following the style of flying that you want from your quadcopter. One of the features that you may really be interested in is the dynamic battery sag compensation. It is enabled with this code that you have to copy and paste in the CLI. This feature will limit your motor's output at the beginning of the flight when your battery is full, and then it will boost your motor outputs when the battery voltage is getting lower. It will result in a more linear flight experience without sag at the end of the flight. I'm not really sure if I'm going to use it with my 6S freestyle quad, but I'm definitely going to give it a try with smaller quads like Cine Whoops or even Tiny Whoops. In conclusion, I'm very happy with this new version of Betaflight that is much more optimized for everyone and that also gives new settings for more cinematic flying and freestyle. I'm really curious about what you think about this update, so tell me in the comments if you like it or not. I will personally try those new features and I will keep you updated with the results. If you want to know more about Betaflight 4.2, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Thanks everyone for watching, take care, and I'll see you next time.